Every state in Nigeria has the presence of these uniformed men referred to as Vehicle Inspection Officers, VIO, whose mandate involves checking of vehicles' particulars and issuing fines to defaulters when necessary. The Vehicle Inspection Officers work with the Vehicle Inspection Service, a directorate under the Ministry of Transportation. Flowing from the overlapping functions of the VIO and the Federal Road Safety Corps, a development that conflicts with the law, a lawyer approached the court in Delta State challenging the legality of the VIO operations. Consequent upon the appeal against the lower court verdict by the Vehicle Inspection Service, an appellate court, also sitting in Asaba, questioned the morality of a VIO in issuance of roadworthiness to private vehicles owner and thus upheld the judgment of the lower court. Legal practitioners are unanimous in their decision that the court's ruling should be respected.
The court has pronounced on it that yes, a private owner of vehicle or users of private vehicle needs no roadworthy certificate before they can drive on the road, either state or national or federal route. Well, I think that's the position of the law. What anybody thinks about that now or think is correct or not correct has nothing to do, has no bearing on the rule of law. And the principle of rule of law dictates that once the court has pronounced on anything, then that should be the position. Even if that decision or order of the court is wrong, now we have a duty, all of us, to obey the ruling of the court.
So the court did very good work. It looked at the regulations, it looked at the law that established the VIO, and the court came to the conclusion that it has no business standing on the road and stopping private vehicles. So I agree with the judgment completely, and I think our public institutions will do well to respect judgments of court. That is the only way we can get our society working, because we are a democratic society, and democratic societies can only function properly if we obey the rule of law.
However, Special Advisor to the Governor of Ondo State on Transport, Toby Ogunleye, disagreed, arguing that it is the duty of the state governments to legislate on vehicle administration devoid of judicial interference.
A bruha had been generated from the so-called Court of Appeal judgment on limiting the power of VIO to commercial vehicle alone. Even logically speaking, it is wrong. I believe the judgment was taken by curiam. There is no special office for registering private vehicles. The same office that is registering commercial vehicles is the same office that is registering private vehicles. Contrary to the erroneous impression that it is the Federal Road Safety that is doing driver license, it is VIO. Every driver license carries the signature of the chief VIO of any state. So why are you now saying that the private car owner should be immune from the routine check of the VIO?
Ogunleye said the public should not allow themselves to be misled, as VIOs in Ondo State have the constitutional rights to inspect vehicles, with emphasis on the residual power of the state government to legislate on transport matters within its territory. Joy Pius, OSRC News.